So I created a video that kind of explored what Fire Pro Wrestling Move Creator was all about. But today I wanted to dive a little deeper and give you kind of a sense of how this works and the easiest way that you can create some moves in Fire Pro Wrestling World, MoveCraft. And I figured that since I know a little bit, I've been messing around with it. I do a lot of stuff just, you know, I'm bored and I'm like, ooh, you know, it'd be cool to kind of put these moves together and see what goes on. You can do some cool things here in Fire Pro. I can show you some of the stuff that I have created, and then I'll show you kind of a sense of how to like get into what you're kind of trying to do. The easiest way to do it, they do have some videos out there that tell you exactly what to do, but this is going to be a simplified version of that, I guess. So I created the border toss here, which I'll just play out for you. And it's nothing new. I probably want to tweak the animation, to be honest, because I don't like how I think he needs to take a step forward or something. I mean, that could be a little bit different. So I created that one. They did have like a outsider's edge, but he goes to his knees. And then there's a couple other ones that you go to your knees or whatever. And then I created this go to sleep type move, which I don't think I have the name of it. I don't know what I'm calling it. But there is, boom, that. I like it. It's like a press slam, go to sleep. Now, I don't actually, well, I guess I kind of, I don't know. The shadow's a little bit weird here, and I'll go into that in a minute. I kind of want the shadow to stay here, but we'll go into that. And then there's one other move I was going to show off that I really do like. If I go back here. Load custom data, and I think this is the other one. Yeah, the choke slam RKO move. I think the shadow moves a little bit here, if I'm right. Yeah, well, it's not too bad. All right, so anyway, I figured out the simplified version to do this. So basically, when you're doing here, you want to load the preset data. You got to figure out what you're going to do for your starting move. What I have decided here, actually, there's one more move I wanted to show off here. I got to remember where I put it. I don't think the shadows are great on this. Maybe it was this one. Oh no, this one's perfect. There's two people here for some reason. I don't know. I'll have to fix that. I think I gave up on that one. But basically, he picks him up and he stabs him with a fork. Which I thought was really cool. Okay. Anyway, so back to what I was saying. Starting off here, you want to load your preset data, unless you want to go with a custom one. But preset data, you figure out where you're going to start with. Basically, I'm going to go with a front grapple big move. Select multiple ones, whichever one you want. I'm going to go front grapple big move. And I'm probably just going to do like a powerbomb, right? Because that's pretty easy to show off is powerbomb. So we'll do a powerbomb, and we'll decide what animation we want for the powerbomb, starting off here at the beginning of this. So there's a lot of different, I didn't want to click on it. That's my bad. I do that all the time. Load presets, go to powerbomb. There's a lot of different powerbomb animations you can go to. I mean, there's just a pickup powerbomb. There's another one. Again, you just figure out what you want, and then that's going to determine how it plays out. So I'm probably going to pick up the rapid powerbomb, maybe jackknife, if I can find that. There you go. I like the jackknife. That's not actually the original jackknife. The final bomb is what I want. Okay, final bomb, that's how you do it. Final bomb is here, okay? There's the final bomb. You can see what you got going on here, final bomb. All right, so you have to figure out what part of the animation do you want to stop at. Over here, you have the attacker's animation, and over here, you have the defender's animation. Now, let's say you actually really like the powerbomb, but you want to have him land differently, right? Let's say I just want the defender to land differently. You could definitely tweak that here. What I would do then is I would go find the animation that I want for landing. And then off of that, you can decide how you want it to play out. So as you see the jackknife, he lands with his arms open on the mat, or not the jackknife, the original final bomb. He lands with his arms open. Up and open. There it is. And then you can just figure out how you want it to be. If you like that animation, which I think is kind of cool, you could figure out the exact spot that you need for him to come down on his neck like so, which would probably be 16, I think. Probably 16. So 16 would be the one I need to do here. So everything before 16 I could probably delete. So I'll just count 16 and delete. You don't have to do this, but this time I'm going to do it. 1, 2. That's actually the attacker, but I need to go to the defender. 16. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 would be probably how I would do that. Lands on his neck and down he goes. That's pretty cool. So we have that animation. Then we'll go and we will go to the final bomb. We'll go to the defender and we'll find out the part what we need here, which would be right about there, which would be 30. So right about there is where we want to delete everything after that. So we deleted everything after that. So now we have this power bomb, which will give us the defender, which would be boom, which we could actually get rid of that. Just show the defender here, and he lands on his neck and flips over. We will copy all of those, so we'll go down and highlight these. Select copy. We'll go back here to the bomb, and then we will go down, and we will put it right there. Paste. And this might not play out perfectly, but since it's a power bomb, it might actually work out just the same. I'm not sure. We'll see. There might be some tweaking we have to do. So here we go. Final bomb. And I actually think that turned out really well. I mean, there's not a lot that I need to do because I really like how he lands on his neck and flips over. It's just a simplified, like, dude, he just slams him on his neck. Now, if you want to tweak it a little bit to make him go a little bit higher, we could definitely do that. He picks him up, boom, defender goes up. Now I could have him, see, he falls down and sets him on his neck. Boom, there he goes. If I would like my guy to bounce off the mat, right, like here, we could have him bounce off the mat. One of the things I will say here is you could move this FZ. But one of the big issues with the FZ movement is that the shadow is not in the right spot. You definitely need to put the shadow in the right spot. If you don't have the shadow in the right spot, the move's not going to correlate properly. FZ is a way to do it. Also, if you mess around with some of this stuff, which would be like hands, moves, legs, things like that, that's going to make things, you know, you can mess around with what's in front, what's in back, all this stuff. I'll go into that. But as you go here, we're going to make this guy bounce up a little bit here. So if you look at RZ and RY, you can click and you can click. Oh, there he goes there. Okay. We want to bounce off the mat a little bit. So if we move it up, everything else should be moved as well. So we go boom, hits the mat, bounces. And then I kind of want him to come back down here, which would probably be here. So here we're going to have him come back down to the mat, and then it plays the sound effect. The big thing that you have to look here is the damage on the attacker. Where does the damage actually happen? Now, since I copied it, the damage is right there, which is when he hits the mat. If you want it to happen anywhere else, you can do that. But that's pretty much how we're going to do it. Damage goes right there, and that's good. I'm going to see if it looks good when he bounces. So I think that could work. Oh, that actually looks a little bit better, to be honest. Because he does a little bounce and then comes back down to the mat. I actually think that's a little bit better. Yeah, I think that's like literally the way to go. Goes up, goes down, boom. All right, so here's what we want to do. If we would like for him to have a body part be behind it, now this is just something you could do a little bit, you know, however you want to tweak it later. These are for different types of moves. But if you just go over to here and you're on the attacker and you check like whichever body part you click on, like let's say, I don't know what the instant would be, but let's say that we need his hand to be behind this guy. Just saying, this is the position A, B, C, or D. So A would be the very front, B would be the next one, C would be the next one, and then D would be the very back. So you'd go and you'd check that, and that would be how you would decide what parts you need to be in what spot. Like, let's say that you want his leg, which would be the defender, to be behind him for some reason. I don't know why you would, let's say you want this this leg here, this thigh 22 to be behind him. You could just go ahead and do the position, and there it would go. He would be behind it, and that's behind his head. Also, you could do the same with this, which would put it behind it if you put D, and that's kind of how that plays out. We'll undo that, though. Yeah, we'll undo that. But that's how you can do that. If you want to add something else to it, you could definitely add something else here how you fit to do that. You can add faces, thighs, heads. There's a weapon here. Should give you, where's the weapon? There it is. There's a weapon. You can choose different weapons as you go through here. Go to all the different weapons. If you want chairs or whatever, you can have a chair animation. Obviously, we don't want a weapon. We don't want anything here. But yeah, that's how you can add different things. I'll show you another one kind of adding a weapon to it. But the bounce definitely does make it here. Boom. Add the bounce. If you want to do a different sound effect, you could definitely just click on here. This SE is sound effect. And we could do that and see what that sounds like. Probably need to be a little bit different. It's probably going to sound bad. Yeah, I don't like the map. I definitely want to add something else here. Powerbomb mat, that's what it is. Body attack. I don't know what the sound effect sounds like, but you can go through and tweak it as you feel fit. There's a body attack. I don't really like it. That's not that great. Powerbomb mat, that's good. Okay, so we have that. There's that. We can get rid of that. There's our new move. When you're done with that, you want to run the data checker, the ringside checker. That's going to make sure that the move works in-game, and it looks like it is. Fight. If you pause the game, you can go to the move list and see where your move is actually at, which I believe it should just be a big move. Yeah, a big move. So it's original powerbomb. So it's just the B button. As you lock up, you can do it. There it is, dude. I love it. Let's do this. Let's actually add an animation in here during the powerbomb, which will be pretty easy. Let's say that I want to put a taunt in here. And we will load a preset data. And we'll do a taunt. Standing. It should be a taunt. I know there's taunts here somewhere. Choo-choo-choo. I always have issues finding some of this stuff. There it is, taunt. So we have taunts there. Let's go to... Yeah, let's load. No taunt. There we go. Arm raise. We could have him raise his arm. If you want to add a taunt, let's do the longhorn. I mean, why not? Actually, there's got to be something cool here. I got to find something. Backflip. No. Muscle appeal. Yeah, let's do the neck cutting pose. Yeah, let's go. All right. Now we have you. Should be from here all the way to there. So we'll copy all of that. which is 9 frames. So we have 9 frames there, which I don't know if that's going to work, but we will see. Copy. We'll see how many frames it is for 1, 2, 3. All right. So this is where tricky comes in. We have this. Sets him up. Let's make sure we get it. I need to get it paused. There it is. Right there is where we want to do. So we're going to insert these frames. Insert 9 frames, I believe. So what we need to do here is now insert 9 frames of this. Should be from here. Which I would probably have to edit this a little bit just to move this guy to the back. So obviously on the attacker, we have to move this leg, which we could just select it all. Should be this. Yeah, that'll work. And we'll put D, and D. I think that's it. Then we'll just have to do it for the rest. Yeah, D, 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 and D. Okay, and then same on this one. Should be D, D, D here. D here, and D as well, and D as well. Okay, same here. We'll move it. D, D, D. That's good. Put D on that as well. Waist, we'll put D as well. Okay. Same here. We'll put D. D, 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 D. And D. We just have to keep doing that. Do, 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 D, D, D. Keep moving them. There we go. Same with this one. We'll keep doing the D. Put it in the back. All right, there's all D's. We'll do another one. Actually want that in the front, maybe? No, that'll be in the back. Here we go. Okay. And then he picks him up, which should be here, which should be all D's as well. Okay. So I think we have everything good here on this guy. He picks him up, does taunt at 6. We need to replicate these. So actually at 6, I'll just move this hand to the back. This wrist to the back. There you go. D. There you go. D all the way. That needs to be changed again. Should be this. And hand. I'll put that there. That's good. Put that to C. That could be fine. That way he like raises his hand up, which would be fine. I'll go with that. And then he puts it back down. Okay, so at 6, we need to copy for, what did I say? I think it's like 6 to 14, so that's 9 frames. All right, 9 frames here. We want this defender to stay there at 6, so we'll copy this. And we'll insert it 9 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And there it will be. And it should work out properly. We'll definitely check it out here just to make sure it plays smoothly. Boom. Then he puts him up. And down he goes. Boom! We added that little taunt there where he turns and taunts. I think that should work. Boom. There it is, dude. Let's go. And that is how you do it. Up and down. So added that in there. Picks him up. Final powerbomb. Let's test it out. Run the data checker. Make sure everything works out. And we shall be good to go here. All right, it looks like we have too many frames in there, which is something that you need to test for. Wow, I didn't expect that. Let's go ahead and test that. Return. Defender. How many frames does this go for? This goes for 47, and this goes for 45. So we definitely have too many frames in here. Probably this one. Probably just get rid of a couple. Delete. Actually, this is the one. It starts right here. Let's try it out. There we go. Yep, we have too many frames in there, so we're just going to have to delete these. And the time is 40, which I think might be the issue here. I believe that's what the issue is here on this 40. So if we just delete these, I think that might be the issue here. Yeah, that's definitely the issue here. Definitely these 40 seconds. Which is 8 seconds pretty much on that. So we'll just delete some of these frames here. And we'll see where this goes. Close. I think we need to get rid of one more or fix the time on it. And then that might make it work perfectly. So we'll delete that one. Close. We just need to delete one more. And that should be good. We could test it out. Close. We're so close here, though. So if we have this time, we'll increase it. See how this looks. It's close. Put it to 55 to see how it plays. Yeah, we're gonna need to go up more. Go to 65. $99. We'll increase this one as well to 50, which might actually make it better. This is something I never encountered. I didn't expect it to be encountered. If I put it at 60, is that? Yeah, we're going to have to move it down a little bit, which will go to 50. Put it at 55. This is where you just mess around and see what works and what doesn't. Some of these animations just don't want to line up. And again, we're a little off, so we'll go to 40, see where that's at. It's close. We probably need to go to like 35, maybe. Could be off. I could do the math and figure it out properly, but for the time being. And that's about as perfect as you can get. Might be able to tweak it a little bit, but I think that's about perfect. Something I just didn't expect. There it is. Let's go ahead and try it out. Make sure it looks good in the thing. And again, you have to figure it out on your own on how you want it to play out. You definitely do. If it doesn't work, you got to do it again. And perfect. I did not expect it to turn out the way it did. I thought it was going to work just fine, but it did not. And I do love the way he bounces off of the power bomb. I think that's like perfect. He just bounces, gets flipped inside out. Man, is that good or what? There's like a couple frames I would probably remove here. Or just move the frames down. I don't know how I would do it, but there's definitely some things I would do here. Like basically my like, okay. So when you play it out here and he goes up, okay, he picks him up, play it out, picks him up. Basically, after he does the taunt, wherever it's at, which is fine. After he does his taunt, I don't know why it looks like that when it definitely does work. It definitely does work. Basically, after the taunt, I just remove a couple frames here or change the frame time to make it differently, but it definitely plays out exactly how we want it. Does a taunt. I think here, when he stops here, he does the taunt and then he stops for a second. And he just stands here for a minute. I'd probably get rid of some of those frames. But now that you got the power bomb working correctly, you test it again just to make sure you did all your final changes. If it works good in the game, you mean it's going to work good in the game. That's what you need to know. Fight. There you go. It's all good. You can go ahead and save it. And then you can get it on the Fire Pro Store or wherever you want to put it. The Steam Workshop, I will call it. Not the Fire Pro Store, but there is no store. All right, so we got that. Then we can do the save it here. First, we have to save it. We're going to call this the Final Cut. It's not Final Cut. Throat Cut Power Bomb. Throat Cut Final Bomb. There it is. Throat Cut Final Power Bomb. Copy that name. There it is. All right. So now that we got the Throat Cut Final Power Bomb, we can register the data. It is registered. You can now assign it. Now here's what you want to do. Yes, currently saved. Yes. Okay. Throw cut final thing. Now you go to edit mode, workshop, publish items, move. Then you can go to the Powerbomb custom, which I think is this. Yes. No. It should be this one. Yep. And we will call this the throat cut final powerbomb. Last ride power bomb with throat cut animation created by at Tony Pizza Guy. There it is. You can add some stuff here. Version 1.0. And the reason you want to do for different versions is because if you change it, you can let people know what you added to the change. It's kind of like change notes, obviously. So write version 1.0. And if you change it, write like version 2.0, made animation smoother, something like that. Just so people know, okay, this is what they changed in it. You know, it's like dev notes. So there it is. Visibility, it will be public because I want anybody to be able to download it. It is a front grapple power and a power bomb move. Now pick your thumbnail, which I think I'm just going to pick that and finalize my revision. And add the item to the Steam Workshop. Add item. Creating the thumbnail and publishing the data. Boom. There it is. Your item is now published and people can go ahead and download it. That's pretty cool. So there you have it, guys. There was creating a move in the Fire Pro Movecraft. If you guys do have any questions, let me know in the comment section below. Biggest thing I will say, though, is make sure those shadows are correct. Move the shadow. Make sure the guy's over the shadow. That's the biggest thing. Edit the body parts if you need to make it look smooth. Add some little frames in the middle. Mess with the time. And you know what? You'll have a pretty cool way to do this. So if you guys do have any other questions, let me know in the comments section below. I can definitely make a part two of this video. But for now, we're going to leave it at this. Here's our Fire Pro Movecraft, the final cut, throat cut, power bomb thingy, whatever I called it. The throat cut final power bomb. It's a throat cut last ride and picks him up. And down he goes. There it is. Anyway, guys, that's going to be it for today. If you enjoyed this, smash like. Let me know in the comment section below what you want to see next. And as always, I'm Tony Beats Guy. We'll see you in another video.